Hi, I'm Adrian Abrams. I'm the Chief Product Owner for the Quality Payment Program at CMS. You can find more information about our program at our website, qpp.cms.gov. In this video, we'll be introducing a new feature that allows clinicians whose organizations submit their quality measures for the purposes of the Merit-Based Incentive Program, MIPS, using the claims-based submission method. What we'll show in this demo is how we've created the ability for a user representing a group practice to log in and to view what will now be a monthly calculation of those claims-based measures. Let's get into the demo. So this is the demo version of the qpp.cms.gov website. As you're aware, as of January 2nd, 2018, a login option became available on qpp.cms.gov. You enter the site by clicking on Sign In. The QPP sign-in screen highlights that we use the Enterprise Identity Management or EIDM user that you may have created for a previous program. We've discussed previously how we've imported around 50,000 existing user accounts as well as their roles. So if you set up an EIDM user and have a role with your organization in support of legacy quality programs, including PQRS, the Physician Value Modifier, the QRUR reports, and or the web interface used for quality reporting and had a valid role, we will have imported that. And if your password is not expired, you'd be able to log in now and view this functionality. If you do not yet have an EIDM user, please visit the CMS Enterprise portal here to obtain a new EIDM user and or request new roles within an organization. Once you're approved, you'll be able to use that user here. To sign in, for the purpose of this demo, I'll be a group practice manager who serves as the security officer in EIDM for my organization. I'm reviewing the statement of truth to confirm that I'll be entering information that is accurate and complete to the best of my knowledge. I've already set up multi-factor authentication on this account. I'm use a cell phone to do that.
Thank you for using our phone verification system. Your code is 16827. Once again,
submit my multi-factor authentication code, and I've now landed on the account dashboard. To be able to see a summary of the results of quality measures submitted via claims, all you have to do is access the appropriate quality measures section of a clinician's submission. Let's quickly show how we do that. So let's collect the group practice that I want to review. I'll go to my first group practice and select to report as an individual, even though it's likely that your organization is the one that's taken the responsibility for adding the appropriate codes to the claims they submit on behalf of a clinician. The actual quality measure that we calculate off claims is calculated at the TIN NPI level. So it's calculated for a specific clinician within the group practice. This means that to see the results of claims-based quality measures, you have to select to go look at the results of individual clinicians within your group practice to see those measure results. That's why I've selected individual submission. In this example, there's one connected clinician, Luis Belcher. Just a quick disclaimer, this information is not yet available in production to users. This is the MIPS eligibility information. We're just right now testing with users the ability to include it. So for the purpose of this demo, please disregard that. We'll talk about that sometime in the near future, we hope. So to be able to see the claims-based measures for Louise Belcher, we want to look at the components of her submission. The quality measures component would be where we were going to locate those measures. Even in a scenario where we have not previously entered any data or uploaded any file on behalf of Louise Belcher, you will see a submission summary scoring screen appear because this is an example of CMS taking the claims that we've received, calculating the quality measures using those claims. And then one way to think about it is that we have created submissions on your behalf and sent them into qpp.cms.gov for you. If Louise Belcher does not currently have a submission when we send that data in, we'll create a submission and populate it only with quality measures labeled under the type claims, as you see here in this example, as the submission method, because we've calculated them off of claims. If previously a submission has been created for Louise Belcher, we will just add this claims submission method to the existing submission, and so there will be an additional dial that will appear if the user has already submitted using the EHR submission mechanism or the registry submission mechanism, as an example. As you can see, we project a score associated with the measures that we have submitted because the measures are scored against benchmarks in real time. Here, we're projecting 51.5 out of a total 60 potential points for those measures calculated off of those claims. In our claims submission summary, we're highlighting the fact that we have not yet achieved the 60 days past the performance period that is required in regulation to call this data final. So this is a projection of how measures are tracking from what we calculate. Moving forward, we aim to calculate these measures once a month and update the site once we calculate them. Below is the claim submission detail area. You'll see the first section contains the six measures that were deemed to have scored the highest. For each measure,
we use
the exact same layout as we use for other quality submission methods. You'll see each measure will receive this horizontal bar. The measure name and measure ID will be listed. The performance rate received will be listed. A projected measure score summary will be here, and specifications are available for download. If you hit the drop-down arrow to the left of the measure name, let me show you an interesting example. You'll see here on the left side of the measure name, a drop-down arrow. The horizontal blue bar highlights the benchmark deciles. The white circle demonstrates the performance rate submitted. In this case, 90% was submitted, which lands in the sixth decile. On the right-hand side here, collapse this. On the right-hand side here, you'll notice the performance points. So first, it is the points achieved from the benchmark decile. That is 6 for landing in the 6th decile, plus the partial points for the location within the decile. The second section highlights the bonus points associated with this measure. This measure did not receive a high priority outcome or patient experience bonus point. It did receive an other high priority bonus point, but no end-to-end reporting bonus point. The totals to a total of 7.3 points projected. Again, remember that this data will be recalculated for this measure, and should we receive any new claims that would impact the measure, we would recalculate this again next month. So this first section captures the highest 6 performing measures and summarizes the points available. You'll notice the highest 6 performing measures scored 50.5 points. The next section captures any measures that earned bonus points. In this case, there's one additional measure that earned a bonus point. And the last section highlights any measures submitted that did not count towards those quality points. So that concludes our demo of the claims-based quality measures feature on qpp.cms.gov, which allows you to see those projected both measure performance rates as well as the scores based on current benchmarks. One last note, just remember that if you also choose to submit for this clinician quality measures via a different method, so for example, EHR or registry, the clinician at the time of final scoring at the close of the submission period will be credited with the highest score from any one of those quality submission methods. So there's never a downside to reporting via an additional mechanism if when you log in, you see the summary of claims-based quality measures already appear. At the end of your session, you'll be able to log out. Remember, there's no need to save or submit. Thank you very much for your time. If you have any additional questions, please visit qpp.cms.gov. And if there are questions further still, feel free to contact the Service Center. The contact information is available there. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.